Most Kenyans are waiting with bated breath for Monday, when President Uhuru Kenyatta is expected to address the nation concerning the virus restrictions in the country, which have played havoc with the lives of Kenyans right across the board. They have affected the economy in a very major way. And the truth is, most Kenyans are expecting the restrictions to be fully lifted. However, if you have information from my very latest weekly intelligence briefings, you will know that that is not going to happen. According to impeccable sources, the best we can expect as Kenyans is only a partial lifting of some of the restrictions, and not all of them. There is very strong resistance against the opening up of Nairobi and Mombasa, the biggest city in the country, and the second biggest, which is also a coastal city, Mombasa. There is much less pressure against the lifting of the curfew, the 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. curfew, which is currently in place. What that means is a lifting of the curfew is much more likely than a lifting of the ban of entry into Nairobi and Mombasa. And everything has a reason. And this position, of course, there is a reason behind it. But there's another challenge that the government faces in lifting the curfews just now, and it is the increased crime. Most Kenyans will not want to hear this, but it is a fact. Even if you consult security experts in the know, it is a fact that the curfews have helped a great deal to keep crime from escalating even further, because criminals operate best in the cover of darkness. Allowing criminals a free hand to move around beyond curfew hours will definitely have an impact on crime, even crime that takes place in broad daylight, because the cover of darkness is what is used to prepare and organize. Actually, it is a very tricky position that the government is in right now, because government officials are fully aware of the sentiments of the vast majority of Kenyans, who are fed up of the restrictions. They're tired of the restrictions. Many believe, although this is not correct, but many believe a lifting of all restrictions will have a magical impact on the economy. It'll be able to improve their financial situation overnight. That is the belief of a vast majority of Kenyans, who don't seem to be aware of the fact that the damage already done to the economy will take quite some time to repair. Bottom line, if you have already packed your bags, if you have already prepared to travel after Monday, you'd better unpack and be more cautious, be less optimistic as you wait for the president to address the nation on Monday. But why? Why are we in this situation? Why is it that the restrictions cannot be fully lifted? Well, when you take in my latest weekly intelligence briefings, you will have all the answers to those questions, and you'll fully understand why. And this information also includes full evidence, which we point out, to prove the accuracy of this highly sensitive inside information. Now, I urge you to take full advantage of our current very special offer, which you have had to extend, because times are hard. which gives you a golden opportunity to be a life member of the weekly intelligence briefings. And I believe you can see all the details on your screens right now. Yeah, just send a blank email to that email address, youmissthis@gmail.com, and you'll get an automatic response within seconds, yeah, giving you full payment details and what you need to do in order to get not only life membership of weekly intelligence briefings, yeah, which will give you all past recordings, highly sensitive stuff, very fascinating for you to go through this weekend, of past weekly intelligence briefings. But it will also give you the very latest, yeah, the information I'm talking about, yeah, the sensitive information that explains in black and white why restrictions cannot be lifted. And I assure you, and I bet, it is not what you're thinking. I myself was shell-shocked when I got hold of this information. I really couldn't believe it. Indeed, I had to wait for confirmation. Or rather, a second independent source, yeah, repeating, verifying the same highly sensitive information. Yeah, so I really look forward to seeing you on the other side in my weekly intelligence briefings. Stay strong. Kenya, we shall overcome. Indeed, remember the saying, it is always darkest before dawn. Yeah, before the light comes, the night is extremely dark. And this is not a reason for you to give up. No, it isn't. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha.